story of the silverback chevrotain, at least my involvement in it, really started in 2017. That's when Global Wildlife Conservation released a list of the 25 most wanted lost species. They had compiled a list of 1,200 lost species, and lost species are animals, plants, insects, things that we know used to be out there and that are now missing, haven't been seen for decades. It's quite likely many of them are extinct, but the hope is that some of them are still around. And so Global Wildlife Conservation, which is a conservation NGO, created this list of 25 that they wanted to try and find that were sort of interesting for different reasons. And one of those animals was the silverbacked chevrotain. And I, as a reporter, have always been very interested in animals that are unique and strange and different. And so this list really captured my imagination. Chevrotains, which are colloquially called mouse deer, are really cool animals. They are not deer and they are not mice. They are rabbit-sized hoofed mammals, ungulates, and they are some of the oldest ungulates in the world. They diverged about 50 million years ago, so they're a really interesting family. And I have seen some in the wild, and when you see them in the wild, they're just so small, and they do look like tiny deer, so you can understand that impression. But they're quite different from deer. They have four hooves. They have fangs that they have, and they're really just cool animals. And there's some research now, some speculation that these are really the ancestors of the animals that would have eventually turned into whales and hippos and things like that. Scientific observations of chevrotain, especially the species in Africa, but also a number of species in Asia, of them using water and going underwater and staying submerged for quite a long time. So it's a really cool animal. The other reason why this matters is that this is the only chevrotain that is only found in Vietnam. It's totally endemic to Vietnam. It's only found in this one area that so far that we know of Vietnam. Scientists are now looking in some other places. And the reason that that's exciting is because Vietnam is going through a wildlife crisis right now with poaching, snaring, deforestation, like many places in Southeast Asia. Wildlife is just being wiped out. And so the fact that this animal is still there shows the resilience, and it gives us a hope and a chance to preserve this animal as well as other animals in that region. In 2018, Global Wildlife Conservation and I had been speaking for a little bit, and they had told me that they were going to go on an expedition to try and find the silverback chevrotain, and that was going to involve really setting up camera traps in an area that had historically been one of the areas that this species had been found, and they were somewhat hopeful that maybe they had a shot of seeing it again. In May of this year, I found out from them that the expedition had succeeded. But of course, at this time, I could not tell anyone that this animal had been rediscovered. So in conversation with them, I was already going to be out in Southeast Asia anyway. And so I said, hey, can I maybe pop over there and go to where this animal had been found? And my interest was really to go and see the habitat and to kind of get a sense of the story. I hoped that I might be able to actually see the animal because the scientists had captured it on camera trap, got lots of photos of it on camera trap, but none of the scientists had actually seen it in the flesh. So I thought, well, this would be kind of a fun adventure. I'll go see if I can see it, talk to local people, get a sense of what the habitat looks like and how the protected area is. We had to find a local wildlife guide that we could trust with this secret and be able to help me find this animal and kind of put me in touch with local people because I speak no Vietnamese. I have never been to Vietnam. And then it was just a matter of getting there and then having this adventure of two nights going out to look for this animal. And I'm not gonna tell you in this interview what happens because it's more fun if you just read the article and you can find out for yourself what happens in relation to trying to discover this lost species that has been found.